Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs is a presentation of Kentucky Proud.
Right now on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, a triple crown of top Kentucky chefs sharing the secrets to some of their favorite recipes.
You know the secret to this?
I'm going into the kitchen at Churchill Downs, where they're using as many local products as possible.
All the local ingredients.
We'll meet the farmers and the artisans who make the ingredients.
So much more flavor.
And learn the secrets to making these amazing dishes at home.
You're making it your own?
Plus, Tim Laird goes into the mansion at Keeneland for the secrets to a great steak and how to make a smoked salad. All of that and artichoke fritters at a restaurant right in the heart of horse country.
That's what this show's all about.
Winning recipes from a triple crown of top chefs.
Downtown Triple Crown.
Right now on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. We're glad to be with you for another exciting edition of Secrets. I'm Kevin Harnett at Churchill Downs, where Kentucky pride shines all year long. And it's more than just horse racing. You can actually taste what makes Kentucky so great, thanks to the work of local farmers who flood the track with fresh ingredients. And Chef David Danielson, who turns it all into unforgettable meals.
One of the things I'm really proud of is our partnerships here with our local farms.
A lot grows here in Shelby County at Courtney Farms. Here, Mary Courtney, her husband Shane, and their four kids are working hard this time of year. Well, most of them are anyway. On about 200 acres, the Courtneys grow just about everything you can in Kentucky.
Beets and radishes, to onions, to eggplant, cucumbers, huge assortment of peppers, watermelons, honeydew.
And many of those items grown at Courtney Farms make their way right here into the kitchen at Churchill Downs. I'm with Chef Dave Danielson.
You know, the secret to this is really the great work that the farmers do. Courtney produces amazing things for us. This is one of my favorite salads. This is a tomato watermelon salad.
All right.
So we've got all these beautiful kind of heirloom tomatoes, some little reds, some yellows. We've got some little cabernets. So we've got some watermelon we dice. It's really a nice play on this sweetness and the kind of acidity from the tomatoes. We've got a little bit of sliced red onions. We've got some beautiful local cucumbers. Another unusual product, some smoked sea salt from Bourbon Barrel Foods. We've got some lemon oil.
Lemon oil, okay.
Put some nice basil in here. We've got some fresh mint here. It's Derby Day. You know, we've got abundance of mint running around this place. If you've never tried mint and tomato, it's really a great combination. So we just kind of mix this together. You know, I like to let this sit maybe an hour or so, make it, put it up. The flavors really start coming together. Tomato watermelon salad. It's really easy to do when you know the secret.
You gotta love that. A Derby dish in which you can actually taste Kentucky pride. Chef, you know what that tastes like? Just like Derby.
Very good.
All year long, we say that we are Kentucky proud, Courtney Farm proud, and now we can say we're Derby proud.
Of course, the cooking never stops at Churchill Downs. Chef Dave is busy all year long for race meets and a lot of special events, too. The same is true at Keeneland, where we find my broadcast partner, Tim Laird.
Everybody loves race day at Keeneland, but if you're a foodie, any day can be legendary here.
These days, Keeneland is as much about world-class cuisine as it is about the equine industry.
A whole new Keeneland. Keeneland Hospitality is really doing some amazing things.
Mark Therian came to Keeneland from San Diego's La Costa Resort and Spa in 2016. And since then, things have never tasted better.
I'm gonna have another bite.
Chef Mark kept all the classics like burgoo and bread pudding, but now he's offering a new approach to Kentucky cooking all year long.
Yeah, we go all year long. So then we got the race meets, we got the sales, but then we also do special events all in between that. So we do it from weddings to corporate events, and we really mix it up.
And keeping it fresh with all our Kentucky proud items.
Yeah, I love it, Chef.
The race course is a perfect setting for special occasions and business events, from large weddings to smaller intimate affairs in the historic mansion, which sits just down the hill from the racetrack. It's a hidden gem in the bluegrass that's perfect for business breakfasts, brunches, and private dinners made just for you.
You could customize. You told me earlier you had a wedding and the bride came in and said, you know what, these are my favorite ingredients. You took that and customized it for them and really created kind of their own meal.
What's your favorite ingredients? We'll take all those ingredients and build you an event just for you.
Here's an example of how Chef Mark is reinventing classic dishes. It's his smoked burrata caprese salad. Burrata is a young mozzarella cheese that's nice and soft in the middle.
Nice texture to it.
Nice creamy texture.
It's even nicer when it's cold smoked, and it puts a whole new layer of flavor on the caprese salad.
I like the idea that you're actually gonna take this fresh burrata and smoke it. And this is something we can do at home. So
what we're gonna do is lay them out like this. Now, something that has been on the market for quite a while is the smoking gun.
He loads up the gun with chips of hickory, covers the pan, and then blows the smoke in through a tube.
Now we're gonna seal the sack up tight, and we're gonna put it right there, let it sit for a good 5 minutes.
All right, so the next step is gonna be our tomatoes.
The tomatoes are the heart of the salad, so make sure you get the best you can. In other words, make sure they're Kentucky proud. Chef Mark has a few secrets to slicing them up.
You grab it like a claw, that's your guide. You cut it right in half.
Great.
You want a sharp knife.
For the bigger ones, he starts the same way, cutting them in half, then in half again. This is when he begins removing the core. It's the secret to not letting any of the tomato go to waste.
We've got our tomatoes.
Now for some greens. The chef is using some Kentucky Proud chicory that he picked up at a local grocery store. And he has some secrets to making it the best it can be.
So the best way to bring your lettuce back is, sometimes when you get to the store, it's a little wilted, it's not dead, you can fix it. So this one is actually good lettuce, but I want it a little stiffer, and it's gonna clean us as well. So I get ice, I get regular tap water. You want this ice cold, hence the ice. And then we're gonna take this and just gonna swirl it around in the ice. Let it sit there, and what's gonna happen, it's gonna bloom that lettuce right back up and give it a little bit of texture that you're looking for. And you can swirl it around, it's gonna do two things. The ice is gonna knock off all that sand and dirt,
right,
and it's gonna liven your lettuce back up again.
And then that'll all fall down, so when you lift it up, you'll be clean.
Yep.
While the greens are chilling, the chef toasts some pistachio nuts for some added crunch to the salad.
I'm gonna put it on there, and now you're gonna shake it. And the best way is to do nice little circle movements. You're gonna give it a whole different flavor when you toast a nut. So I don't wanna put the whole nuts on there, so I'm just gonna put them on the cutting board. Roughly chop them. They don't have to be pretty. That's not what the point is. It's not a pistachio dish. It's just a garnish.
And there's one more surprise for the salad. Chef Mark's minty dill basil pesto.
It just really works. You just take your basil. There's no need to sit there all day and trim it. Just twist it and break it off.
That goes right into the food processor.
You take a little bit of mint.
Then he adds a little dill and some crushed garlic.
That's about as much garlic as I want to put in.
Another secret, fresh lemon zest.
So I just take that, just the lemon rind, a lot of good flavor in that.
There's also good flavor in the juice, so he puts that in too, along with some grapeseed oil, just a little at first.
So I'm gonna start it off just to get the herbs going. And we're almost there.
Once it starts blending together, the chef adds more oil, slowly, until he gets that perfect pesto texture.
That's pretty much the pesto right there. Now, I didn't put any cheese, I didn't put any nuts in this because it's already in the dish.
So now it's time to put everything together on the plate. Watch as the chef turns the salad into a piece of art.
It's all visual too, you eat with your eyes. Put it in the center of each plate. One, two, three, four, two red and a yellow. It can be whatever you want.
The lettuce is ready in the ice bath.
Take that, I'm just gonna shake it off. I don't do this at home.
A great technique. It's the salad shake.
You see how that ice just woke that up?
Oh yeah, beautiful. It just came alive.
And then that smoked mozzarella cheese.
It's very, very, very soft. Put it right in the center.
marketing, Chef. This looks absolutely fabulous.
It's all about plate design.
A few more of the smaller tomatoes go on, along with those chopped pistachios. Then, a little extra virgin olive oil, accompanied by some good 18-year-old balsamic vinegar.
Spend the extra money, it goes a long way.
It's expensive, but all you need is a little bit to give it a good...
The vinegar is the acid we're looking for. It's going to wake this up. And so at the end, just a little flake of salt.
Just a little bit, not much, a little pinch.
And that's the dish.
That is absolutely gorgeous. You're taking an idea of, you know, a standard caprese salad, but you're making it your own.
Mm-hmm.
You're making it even better.
Beautiful.
I'll have more from Keeneland coming up, including Chef Mark's secret to the perfect steak, which involves apples of all things. Thanks, Tim. Also ahead, the chef at Churchill Downs shows me his twist on shrimp and grits with a special ingredient made right here in Louisville. Stay with us for more Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs.
Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs is a presentation of Kentucky Proud. Nothing else is close. With support from the Kentucky Beef Council. In Kentucky, beef is still what's for dinner. And by PNC Bank, for the achiever in you.
I'm Natalie Reese, the owner of Cooking at Millie's. We bring in local chefs from restaurants all around Louisville to walk you through a three-course meal. It's a fun evening of you making dinner, eating, and learning a few things while drinking a glass of wine. We would love for you to join us one evening. Cooking at Millie's is for everyone. You know, bring a friend, bring your significant other, bring whoever you want. Just have a great dinner and a great night out.
Enjoy exceptional and authentic Mexican cuisine at Gustavo's Mexican Grill, now in Norton Commons. It's food that goes way beyond burritos and tacos. Everything from seafood to sizzling fajitas, homemade moles, and fresh soups that eat like a meal. The bar is stocked with all your favorite things, too. Don't miss $3.99 Margarita Days, every Tuesday, all day long. Taste and feel the authenticity at Gustavo's Mexican Grill in Crestwood, LaGrange, Prospect, and now in Norton Commons.
Welcome to Veronese Restaurant on historic Frankfort Avenue. Veronese is the perfect setting for your next celebration. We have private dining rooms that can accommodate large or small groups. Give us a call and let Veronese take care of the rest.
Make food service easier with help from Dine Company, the restaurant store. If you prep, cook, or serve food, we serve you. Shop Louisville's largest selection of new and used food equipment and smallwares in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our people make at Dine Company, family-owned and operated since 1982.
Summer says enjoy, and so does Ditto's with citrus Atlantic cod. Sauteed North Atlantic cod filet atop smashed potatoes in a tangy citrus sauce, topped with lemon and basil. Ditto's Grill, Bardstown Road at Grinstead Drive.
Kevin Harned with you again on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, where this time we're dining out in horse country. We'll check in with Tim Laird at Keeneland in a few minutes. And right now, I'm with Dave Danielson, the executive chef at Churchill Downs, who's sharing the secrets to his signature shrimp and grits, a huge hit both on Derby weekend and throughout the year.
The secret to this dish is actually some local grits.
The grits he uses come mostly from organic corn.
The organic corn has so much more flavor.
Which gets milled right here in Louisville.
A small batch mill.
At Louis Mill.
The Louis Mill, Louisville, you know, the whole, multiple ways to say it.
Tom Edwards takes a lot of pride in every small batch.
The process is very slow, so it doesn't heat up the corn and preserves all its natural freshness and the natural sweetness that's in it.
Chef Dave Danielson is here. It's great to see you.
Great to see you again. We're going to make a little shrimp and grits. I'll show you how we do it. So we got 2 cups of water, 2 cups of milk, to 1 cup of grits. We just get this nice and hot. I'm going to slowly add these grits in. Take about 20 minutes or so, 15 to 20 minutes. We're going to put a little bit of shrimp in here. We're going to pull these shrimp out of here real quick. Want to hand me that corn?
Sure. This looks like nice sweet corn.
Yeah, it's nice sweet corn. So we're going to throw a little bit of that in. Just give this a little saute for a minute or so. So these are a little heirloom tomato halves. We put the shallots in towards the end.
I mean, that in itself looks good. And we're not anywhere finished
Absolutely.
With the dish.
We're going to finish these shrimp back in here now. Give me a little bit of basil. Right. So just tearing a little bit up in there. Garden freshness.
Yeah, it's nice to know that mint's not the only fresh herb being used here at the track.
No, we've got tons of all different types of things. I'm just gonna throw a couple pads of butter in that. It all comes together here. We've got their grits pretty much ready to go here. A little bit of butter in there. Nicely grated Parmesan cheese. This bourbon smoked sea salt from Bourbon Barrel Foods. These guys make some amazing products. Cheesy, creamy grits. Start placing our shrimp. Now we've got that corn that's been cooking.
A little bit of the sauce.
Tomato, sauce, butter.
Oh.
Take a taste.
All right, let's do this.
If you've ever wondered why the food on Derby weekend tastes so good at Churchill Downs, you can thank Chef Dave and proud local producers like Tom Edwards at Louis Mill.
Thank you for allowing us into your kitchen on such a busy day.
Well, thanks for being here.
Meanwhile, Tim Laird is busy cooking at Keeneland. The chef is letting him in on the secret to grilling everything from chicken to steak, and it's probably the last thing you would expect. Tim?
It's all about apples, believe it or not. Apple brine, that is.
The brine is the magic of any good, if you're gonna smoke something or if you're gonna even just sear it on a pan. You know, I take a flat iron steak, this is great with flat iron. You know, I take a flat iron, let it sit overnight, and then I sear it in a cast iron pan. Beautiful.
It helps keep it moist. Is that the primary thing, or are you getting flavor too, or what's?
It's both. This one here is good for pork, chicken, and beef.
I like it. Okay.
It's very simple to do. You can do this at home. What you want to do is you want to get first a good stock pot. It's about a gallon of water here. But normally when you're doing a brine, it's equal amount sugar, equal amount salt.
Salt. Okay.
So I'm gonna, for a gallon of water, I'm gonna probably gonna put 3-4 cups of salt. Now the sugar. The next ingredient is honey. Honey is a great sweetener. It's all natural. It's good for you. I can't say enough about it. You know, it melts in there nice. I use fresh bay leaf. You know, I'll put 3 or 4 sprigs in there. That's about enough. It is an apple brine. So instead of putting apple juice, which is loaded with sugars again,
right.
I'd rather put a natural apple in there.
You did a nice chop on that?
I just did a rough chop. I keep the peel on. I keep the core. I keep the seeds. It doesn't matter. We're not making a soup. We're not going to eat this. I just want to flavor it. So we're going to put the apple in there. I got about 5 apples in here. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of peppercorns in there. We're gonna bring that to a boil.
Okay.
What that boil is gonna do is gonna incorporate all the sugar and all the salt and dissolve it into the water. It should taste like the ocean.
Once it's boiled for a few minutes, Mark puts the brine in an ice bath to stop the cooking process.
So you're gonna take it in, and then you're gonna put this in your cooler. Let this get cool completely before you brine anything. When it comes to chicken, if I'm using 8-weight chicken, which is the cut chicken, I would brine it for maybe 10 hours.
Okay.
If I'm doing a whole bird, 24 hours. If I'm doing a whole pork loin, 24 hours. If I'm doing flat iron steaks, I'd probably do it for 12.
12.
So when you get a flat iron steak, this is how we do it. We take the time here to brine, to really go through the process, and it's worth it.
The attention to detail that you're bringing to everything you're doing. Thank you again so much. Just love what you're doing here. 20 to 2,000 people, this is the place.
Thanks, Tim. We have more good secrets to share coming up. Next, artichoke fritters that are known to be the best in the state. We'll take you to the place that serves them and get the secrets to making them at home when Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs return.
Wish your home was smarter? Love technology, but you get frustrated when it doesn't work? You need Automated Lifestyles to make your house a smart home. Control all your home's lighting, audio, video, security, and more with your voice command or just the push of a button. Automated Lifestyles is locally owned and operated and has solutions for every budget. Most of our technology is wireless, so it will integrate with any home regardless of its age. Visit automatedlifestyles.com or call 270-971-4065.
River House Restaurant and Raw Bar, now open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week, featuring the cuisine of Chef John Veronese with a Southern-inspired menu and an emphasis on seafood with a spectacular Raw Bar. River House, right next to the water tower at 3015 River Road. Reservations recommended.
Italian at its finest, Volare. Inspired cuisine by Chef Josh Moore. Intimate dining, private events, and year-round patio seating. Savor Volare. Cocktails and dinner 7 nights a week. Volare on Frankfort Avenue.
As a family, we're proud to have a hand in providing a product that we know is safe and has been grown with integrity for other families to enjoy across the state of Kentucky. There's a lot of love in that package of ground beef and a lot of hard work.
Kevin Hornet back with you on the Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, the show that takes you out to eat at Kentucky's tastiest destinations. And Tim Blair has found another one of those right in the heart of horse country.
Just outside of Lexington on Bryan Station Road, you're going to find a windy corner that serves a lot of tasty food.
And all of it is Kentucky proud. Whether it's chili made with bluegrass beef.
Really good, full of beef, not too many beans. It's really good chili.
Or shrimp and grits, as good as I have ever tasted.
Best shrimp and grits.
I love that.
It's home cooking, made by one of the best chefs in the bluegrass.
But Rita Michael is more than a chef. You could say she's an ambassador for all things Kentucky.
Well, I went to UK, and the summer after I graduated, my dad drove me up to New York City. Pulling a trailer, drove across the George Washington Bridge, and I lived in New York for about 8 years. I met my husband there. I worked in restaurants in Manhattan and then went to culinary school there, but that was many years ago now.
But we're so glad that you came back to the Bluegrass.
Well, you can't ever leave Kentucky.
Oh,
you
know that. And we're glad you did.
At the Windy Corner Market, Rita serves just about every kind of po' boy you could imagine, from tri-tip beef to chicken, and of course, Cajun-style fried shrimp and oysters.
Where do you start and what do you order first? I mean, that's why people keep coming back. You've got to keep trying different things.
Yeah. Very good.
Wonderful.
The po' boys are fantastic, but when you come here, you've got to try the artichoke fritters.
The artichoke fritter is great.
I thought they were amazing. I loved the fritter and I loved the sauce as well.
The sauce is a longtime secret, one that Rita has never revealed. But guess what? That's about to change.
Your secret sauce isn't going to be a secret anymore now that you're on Secrets.
I know, but it's my gift to you.
So get ready to take notes as we head into the kitchen at Windy Corner with Chef Rita and her right-hand man, Chef Mark.
We start out with a number 10 can of drained, chopped artichoke hearts.
Okay.
And we've got feta cheese, we've got Parmesan cheese. We've got Dijon mustard, a little flour, salt, pepper, and vinegar. It's a very, very simple recipe. So we just lightly scramble the eggs. We're gonna add those to the artichoke fritters. And we have flour, we have Dijon mustard, Parmigiano Reggiano, really good Parmesan, and then a really nice crumbled feta. That's probably our secret ingredient to the dish. I think the feta is what gives it the bite and the tang. And then we have just a little salt and pepper and a little bit of extra vinegar. That's just a white wine vinegar.
So everything's all incorporated in there, Rita, and now we're ready for the fryer, right?
It's really incorporated, and Chef Mark will let that sit for about 30 minutes in the fridge before he starts frying it.
Let it sit for about 30 minutes?
Right.
That flour sits in there, all those ingredients. Share the love together.
Yeah.
30 minutes, then?
Right into the
fryer.
Fry
time,
then
all right.
Fry time. And right. So we just scoop them out with a little scoop. See how he's got this 1 ounce scoop here?
All right.
And drops into these fryers are 325 to 350. If you're making these at home, you can just definitely use your little Presto countertop fryer, and it takes about 5 minutes.
You're just looking for that nice golden texture
yeah.
on the outside, when if you know that just looking at that, I can just feel
it's
the
good.
Crispiness on that.
Yeah.
It's just incredible. Look
it's
at
a,
that.
It's a great dish. We serve it with a little bit of our secret remoulade sauce, which is our number one recipe request here at Windy Corner. I've never released the recipe before this time.
This is it, Kay. Never been released. We're going to see the secrets right now with Chef Mark. All right, Chef, you've gathered a crowd here to check on the secret recipe. And I'll tell you what, they all love it. All right, Chef Mark's giving up the secrets. All right, here it is, the secret remoulade.
We do all of it in a food processor, so it's super easy. Yeah, he has parsley and capers and garlic and dried tarragon in there right now, and he's processing all that together.
Okay, that was coarse ground mustard that went in with the seeds.
That's right, with
okay.
the seeds and smoked paprika, and that was fresh lemon juice, and now this is cayenne pepper.
Cayenne pepper, so there's where it gets a little kick to it. And so all that, once it's blended up, goes right into the mayo.
In the mayo. We've got a heavy-duty mayo. That's really important. It's not gonna be the same with a light mayo. I'm sorry. It's kind of like a pesto. It's like a crazy Cajun pesto.
Oh my gosh.
That you're then seasoning the mayonnaise with. And then again, it's just like the fritters. If they sit, it's good.
All right, the secret was just revealed for the first time. You have it now. Now, I know we're supposed to let this sit for a little bit, right? But
I'm not waiting.
I got to do just a, here's a clean spoon. I'll just do a little taste over here. Wow, I can see why people absolutely love this. Creamy. I get a little bit of a kick of the pepper that's coming in there.
And that's even without the fritter. I can imagine what it tastes like with the fritter on top of it, so.
Taste the fritter.
Okay.
We're just claiming this is the best fritter in the Bluegrass.
Are you kidding me?
This is it. This is, I'm declaring this the best fritter in the Bluegrass.
Fluffy and light, and the filling stayed together, and they were crisp on the outside. They were very good.
Downtown, triple brown. Wonderful. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Big crunchy outside, soft center inside, all that remoulade on there.
And I love the sauce that she made too. It was just a great appetizer.
For the first time, that remoulade revealed. I'll tell you what.
Get yourself a big old beer and sit down and have a go to pieces right here in this.
And not leave. I just want to stay right here with my beer and fritters and not go anywhere else. This is it.
Oh, I'm glad you like it. You don't
Unbelievable.
Know.
Very good. The remoulade sauce was wonderful.
Mark, great job. Thank you for showing us the secrets of that. Wida, unbelievable.
Well, thank you
Winner,
so much.
Best Bluegrass fritter. That'll do it for this edition of Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. I'm Tim Laird, and we'll see you next time.
Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs is a presentation of Kentucky Proud.
Make food service easier with help from Dine Company, the restaurant store. If you prep, cook, or serve food, we serve you. Shop Louisville's largest selection of new and used food equipment and smallwares in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our people make at Dine Company, family-owned and operated since 1982.
Wish your home was smarter? Love technology but get frustrated when it doesn't work? You need Automated Lifestyles to make your home a smart home. Control all your lighting, audio, video, and security with your voice or just the push of a button. AutomatedLifestyles.com.
Originally in Tribeca, New York City, Rock is now in Louisville. Rock offers homemade and fresh quality food with an extensive wine and bourbon list. I will ensure that your Italian experience will be memorable. Rock on Barstown Road. Don't miss our once a month disco brunch. Reservation recommended. Ciao, a presto.
Kentucky Proud restaurants have been dazzling diners for decades with food that's unmatched anywhere. They've served us. Now more than ever, it's time for us to serve them. Tim Laird here. Join me in helping to preserve Kentucky's culinary community in this time of crisis by ordering takeout today. Get a list of Kentucky Proud restaurants offering curbside pickup by going to kyproud.com/takeout. Eat good and do good. Help Kentucky keep cooking by ordering Kentucky Proud takeout today.